On this slide, we're going to look at one sarcomere. Recall from the last video that a sarcomere is one unit of contraction in a myofilament. And a myofilament is one cylindrical unit of many inside a muscle fiber, which is a muscle cell. So here's one sarcomere from Z-line to Z-line. Recall that on either side of the Z-line, that span is the light band or I band, where the length of myosin, which are the thick filaments, that's the dark band. So this is just one sarcomere, and we can see that actin in green is overlapping myosin in purple. If we look closely at myosin, we can see it has little arms on it, or little heads, and we call those myosin heads. If we enlarge the myosin, we can see all these little heads, and here's just one of them. If we look a little closer at actin, which is the thin filament in green, we can see that it's made up of all of these little openings or holes. We call those binding sites or active sites. Then myosin heads fit nicely inside these openings. They can't fit inside right now because you can see those openings or active sites are blocked. So we have proteins that you can see in orange and these little yellow balls here. Those proteins act to block these myosin heads from joining on to actin. This is so our muscles aren't always contracted. Myosin cannot bind to actin because of these two proteins that are blocking the active sites, which are troponin, which you see as yellow circles here, and tropomyosin, the two T's, tropomyosin, which are these yellow strings. So as long as troponin and tropomyosin are blocking the active sites on actin, well then, myosin cannot grab on. Myosin needs to form a cross bridge or grab onto actin in order to produce a contraction. And we'll see how that happens on the next slide here. So here's one sarcomere again, from Z-disc to Z-disc. We can see the myosin heads are not bound to actin, and there's a little bit of overlap here. This is a relaxed sarcomere in a muscle fiber. But look at this sarcomere right here. We have Z-disc to Z-disc, which is much narrower than the relaxed sarcomere. So what happened is we have more overlap between actin and myosin. Look at the overlap here versus the overlap here. So what happened is the Z-discs are getting pulled towards the center from either side, making the sarcomere shorter, and that's a contraction. How did this overlap happen? Well, those myosin heads, which we saw on the previous slide, they grab on to actin. That's called a cross bridge, and they slide actin towards the center from either side. When this happens, you can't see them here, but recall troponin and tropomyosin. Those are the proteins that block actin and myosin. We call that contact inhibition. They inhibit contact. Well, they must have been moved out of the way somehow in order for the cross bridge to form and the sliding of the filaments to take place to create more overlap. So the key here is that contraction versus relaxation, the length of the filaments remains the same. Actin and actin, here and here, are the same length. Myosin did not change in length, but what did change is more overlap, creating this contraction or a shorter sarcomere.